Thanks for coming out today. I apologize for the delay. We had some dead batteries in my radio up here, so I couldn't hear what was going on. But we're good to go again, so thank you for your patience. I've just got a couple of things for you as we get started. We extend our Christian sympathy to the Yankage family. Jim is in Philly this morning, preparing to bury his nephew who passed away, so we remember the Yankage family in our prayers. We also remember the Holmquist family. Mike Holmquist's mother, Marilyn, passed away this week, so we remember them. And I think it's also good to remember the royal family. Prince Philip died, as you know, probably last week, and they had the funeral for him yesterday, and I can only imagine how hard that is after nearly 74 years of marriage. Having to say goodbye to your partner would be very, very hard. So we'll remember the royal family this morning as well. It's the last chance to donate shoes for a day without shoes. We still have our barrel, but I understand they're coming to get it on Tuesday. So if you have shoes that you want to donate, I would say bring them by the parsonage either today or tomorrow, or be here first thing Tuesday morning at 8 o'clock, because I imagine they'll be here promptly at 8 to pick that up. So thank you to those of you who have donated shoes. It's very much appreciated. It's good to be back with you after a week of vacation. It was very restful and wonderful to be away, but it's also good to be back. Ken and I were able to go out to Kearney and look at the cranes, and we've never been able to do that before. Usually because of how Easter falls, we either miss it or, well, we've always missed it. But this year we were able to go, and even though it was at the tail end of the season, we still got to see hundreds of them. So we were very glad to be able to do that. And it's good to be back today. So as we begin our worship, let's center our hearts and our minds as we begin with our gathering song.
One day when heaven was filled with his praises, one day when sin was as black as could be, Jesus came forth to be born of a virgin, dwelt among men, my example is he. The Word became flesh and the light shined among us, his glory revealed. Living he loved me, dying he saved me, buried he carried my sins far away, rising he justified freely forever. One day his coming, oh glorious day, oh glorious day. One day they led him up Calvary's mountain. One day they nailed him to die on a tree. Suffering anguish, despised and rejected, bearing our sins, my Redeemer is he. The hand that healed nations stretched out on a tree and took the nails from me. Living he loved me, dying he saved me, buried he carried my sins far away, rising he justified freely forever. One day he's coming, oh glorious day, oh glorious day.
One day the grave could conceal him no longer. One day the stone rolled away from the door. Then he arose, for death he had conquered. Now is ascended, my Lord, evermore.
Death could life could not keep him from rising again.
Rising again.
Living, he loved me. Dying, he saved me. Buried, he carried my sins far away. Rising, he justified freely forever. One day it's coming, oh glorious day. Oh glorious day. Sound for his coming. One day the skies with his glories will shine. Wonderful day, my beloved one bringing. My Savior Jesus is mine. Living he loved me, dying he saved me. Buried, he carried my sins far away. Rising, he justified freely forever. One day is coming, oh glorious day, oh glorious day.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord.
Amen.
This is a feast of victory
for our God. Alleluia, alleluia. Christ, our Lamb who was slain, whose blood set us free to be people of God. Power, riches, wisdom, and strength, and honor, blessing, and glory are His. This is a feast of victory for our God. Alleluia, alleluia. Join in the hymn of all creation, blessing, honor, glory, and might be to God and the Lamb forever. Amen. This is a feast of victory for our God, for the Lamb who was slain has begun his reign. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Let us pray. Holy and righteous God, you are the author of life, and you adopt us to be your children. Fill us with your words of life, that we may live as witnesses to the resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you. The first reading for today is from Acts chapter 3. When Peter saw it, he addressed the people. You Israelites, why do you wonder at this? Or why do you stare at us as though by our own power or piety we have made him walk? The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of our ancestors, has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and rejected in the presence of Pilate, though he decided to release him. But you rejected the holy and righteous one and asked to have a murderer give to you. And you killed the author of life, whom God raised from the dead. To this we are witnesses. And by faith in his name itself has made this man strong, whom you see and know, and the faith that is through Jesus has given him this perfect health in the presence of all of you. And now, friends, I know that you acted in ignorance, as did your rulers. In this way, God fulfilled what he had foretold through all the prophets, that his Messiah would suffer. Repent, therefore, and turn to God so that your sins may be wiped out. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Please read responsive with me Psalm 4. Answer me when I call, O God of my right. You gave me room when I was in distress. Be gracious to me and hear my prayer.
How long, you people, shall my honor suffer shame? How long will you love vain words and seek after lies?
But know that the Lord has set apart the faithful for himself. The Lord hears when I call to him.
When you are disturbed, do not sin. Ponder it on your beds and be silent.
Offer right sacrifices and put your trust in the Lord.
There are many who say, Oh, that we might see some good. Let the light of your face shine on us, O Lord.
You have put the gladness in my heart more than when their grain and wine abound.
I will both lie down and sleep in peace. For you alone, O Lord, make me lie down in safety.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Holy Gospel is from the 24th chapter of Luke. And you may stand if you would like, as you are able. You are welcome to stand for the reading of the gospel. Jesus himself stood among them and said to them, "Peace be with you." They were startled and terrified and thought they were seeing a ghost. He said to them, "Why are you frightened? And why do doubts arise in your heart? Look at my hands and my feet. See that it is I, myself. Touch me and see, for a ghost does not have flesh and bones as you see that I have." And when he had said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While in their joy they were disbelieving and still wondering, he said to them, "Have you here anything to eat?" They gave him a piece of broiled fish, and he took it and ate it in their presence. Then he said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Messiah is to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." The gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Please be seated. Well, friends, I have come to a very important decision in my life. I have decided that I do not like to wear pants. It's one of the many things that I have learned about myself during this time of COVID. And as I sit at the computer, you only see me from the shoulders up. So you have no idea what I'm wearing on the bottom, and I finally realized it really doesn't much matter. I could be wearing my pajama pants, and you'd never know, as long as I don't have to get up for anything during the meeting. But, you know, now that businesses and the hospitals are opening up, I have to be presentable when I go out into the world. And I'm finding that after 14 months of comfortable pajama pants, dress pants are rather constricting and confining. And for someone with long legs such as I, well-fitting pants are very difficult to find. And the problem with women's pants is that they come in three lengths. And for me, that tends to be really short, a little too short, and dragging on the ground. And if I get the pants that are indeed designed for tall women, then the rise is too long, and I end up having parachute pants like MC Hammer in the 80s. It's not a good look. But on that great and glorious day when I do find pants that fit, I usually buy 10 pair of every color that I like, and I will wear them until they are threadbare. And then by the time that those are worn out and I need new pants, I have to start all over again. Since I feel weird wearing pajama pants to church meetings and to worship, and just to be clear, I'm not judging you if you do, it's just me. One of the gifts of COVID has been my discovery of leggings. I've never worn leggings before because I believed they were not for me. I have long legs, and leggings always tend to be a little short. I'm a little thick in certain places, and so they never fit quite right. But I recently discovered some leggings that do work for me, and I love them. I wear them all the time, which means that they will probably be wearing out soon, and the quest for perfect pants will begin again. So what in the world does my confession of my personal struggle with pants have to do with the gospel? Well, I'll tell you. The disciples knew way back then something that I am just now figuring out for myself. They didn't wear pants either. But seriously, here they are, gathered in this room. It's Resurrection Day evening. So it's still Easter Day, even though it's 2 weeks out for us. And the two disciples who encountered Jesus on the road to Emmaus, they have run back to Jerusalem to tell the others what has happened. And suddenly, Jesus himself comes and he stands among them, bringing them a greeting of peace. They don't know what to do. They don't know what to say. They don't know what to think because nothing like this has ever happened before. And even though Jesus prepared them to know what to expect after the crucifixion and looking toward the resurrection, they did not believe him. Much like me, and wearing leggings, the disciples did not believe that the gospel, the good news of Easter, was meant for them. Well, Jesus knows this about them. He knows this group of followers better than they know themselves, and he knows that they are sometimes a little slow on the uptake, and they're a little slow to believe. Sometimes they have to be shown what the truth is. So he asks them for something to eat. And this story tickles me so, because almost every time we see Jesus in the story, he's eating something. And post-resurrection, it's no exception. But it's not because he's hungry. That's not the point. The point is that ghosts can't eat food. And so if he was a ghost, it would have gone right through him, like Slimer in Ghostbusters. But that's not what happens. He shows them that he is real. He is alive. He is flesh and blood right in front of them. He shows them the holes in his hands and in his feet. And he's trying to tell them that everything he said prior to the crucifixion has come true. He's trying to tell them that the good news of Easter is standing right in front of them. He's trying to tell them that the time has come for them to stop doubting and believe. It's hard to accept good news sometimes, even when it's standing right in front of us. Sometimes we think God's grace is good enough for other people, but it's not good enough for us. Or maybe more pointedly, that we are not good enough for it. Not too long ago, I saw a TV show where two pastors were discussing parish life. And there was a member of the first pastor's church who was struggling with an issue that the first pastor themselves had been struggling with. And the second pastor said to the first, "So what did you say to that person?" And the first pastor said, "I told them that it was okay, that their struggle was okay, and that God loves them anyway." And the second pastor said, "Well, then why can't you say that to yourself, child of God? Why can't you say to yourself that whatever you're struggling with, it's okay, and God loves you anyway?" God bless that second pastor. We are always harder on ourselves than we are on others. Amen? At least I am. But the bad part is that this behavior is actually encouraged. It's not okay to judge others. We hear that very clear from Jesus himself. But it seems like we're encouraged to beat ourselves up as much as we want. And that seems to be perfectly okay. And it's not. We extend grace and forgiveness and the love of Christ to others, but it sure is hard to accept it for ourselves. It sure is hard to see how the blood of Jesus covers our own brokenness. But you know what? Every single little bit of our sinful selves has been forgiven. Every little bit of our sinful selves has indeed been redeemed by the blood and the love of Jesus Christ. Now, we all have our blind spots, spots where we don't realize that we're beating ourselves up over this or that or the other dumb thing that we may have done. And yet, if we see someone else struggling with the same thing or something similar, how quick are we to offer words of encouragement to them, but not to ourselves? Why would we do that, child of God? Why can't we realize that the love and the grace that has been granted to us in the Lord Jesus Christ is enough to cover our shortcomings too? My story about pants was pretty silly. At least I hope you thought it was silly. I think it's pretty silly. But I hope you get my point. There are times when we may decide that something is just not for us, and maybe that is truly a legitimate decision. But there are many, many other times when something should be for us, and we decide that it is not. And we make that decision because deep down, we believe that we simply are not good enough to receive the gift. My friends, wearing pajama pants in public may be one of those things. It's just not a good idea. But the grace that comes to us in Jesus Christ is not. It's a very good idea. The love of God that comes to us abundantly and without reservation is a very, very good idea. And it is for us. And no, we don't deserve it. And no, we cannot earn it. But maybe we can learn to recognize it when it is standing right in front of us, like in the waters of the baptismal font, in the nourishment that we are about to receive in bread and wine, in words of scripture and sermon and song, in this community of faith that is gathered here this morning in the chilly parking lot, and the community of faith out there gathered with us online. The love of God comes to us in all of these amazing ways and more. The love of God is a one-size-fits-every-need kind of love. It's never too short, and it's never too long. It never goes out of style, and it is always waiting patiently for us to see it. And maybe best of all, it is always, always, always exactly what we need. Amen.
Jesus is risen, trumpets resounding in glorious light, splendor the Lamb. God the glory, hallelujah. Walking the way, Christ in the center, telling the story to open our eyes, breaking our bread, giving us glory. Jesus, our blessing, our constant surprise. Jesus is risen and we shall arise. Give God the glory, hallelujah. Jesus, the vine, we are the branches. Life in the Spirit, the fruit of the tree. Heaven to earth, Christ to the people. Gift of the future now flowing to me. Jesus is risen and we shall arise. Give God the glory, hallelujah. Weeping be gone, sorrow be silent. Death put asunder and Easter is bright. Cherubim sing, oh give us hope. Hold us in wonder, adorn us in life. Jesus is risen and we shall arise. Give God the glory, hallelujah. City of God, Easter forever, golden Jerusalem, Jesus our Lamb, river of life, saints and archangels, sing with creation to God I am. Jesus is risen and we shall arise. Give God the glory, hallelujah.
We are God's people by baptism into Christ. Living together in trust and hope, let us confess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us now join our hearts and our minds together in prayer. Gracious and loving God, we give you thanks for this day. We thank you for the warmth of the sun. We thank you for pleasant weather this morning as we gather outside to worship you together. And we're grateful for those who are joining us on Zoom, that they can be with us too. Lord, sometimes we don't recognize the truth even when it is standing right in front of us. Sometimes we believe that your grace and your love are not a good fit for us, and yet you promise us that they are. Your grace, your love, your presence in our lives are always exactly what we need. We ask that you enter into those places, Lord, that are in need of that love and grace and encouragement. Enter in and bind up those places within us that are broken, those places that we feel are not worthy of your love, of your forgiveness, of your reconciliation. Heal us, O God, and set us free, that we may be your people and your light and love in the world. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray, Lord God, for your church throughout the world, and we ask a blessing on every faithful heart who gathers in your name. We pray, Lord, that you would strengthen us for such a time as this, that we can indeed be your servant people and be your light and love to those who need it most. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the nations of the world, particularly places that are living with disunity, discord, injustice, or violence. We pray for the leaders of the world, that their hearts would be moved to justice and peace as they govern their people. And we pray for the peoples of the world, that as we work together, we grow together, help us to grow in peace and in love toward one another, that as we look into the face of the stranger, we can see there a face of love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for our nation. Our nation is hurting in so many ways. There are many who are still suffering from COVID. There are many who are grieving those who have died from this disease. And coupled with that, gun violence is huge right now. It seems like every day we turn on the TV and we hear of yet another shooting. Lord God, let your peace rest on our land. Let your peace rest in our hearts. Give us grace and love and patience and tolerance with one another. Help us to learn that violence is never a good choice. And for those who are hurting, for those who are wounded, for those who are grieving the loss of loved ones due to gun violence, we pray, Lord, that you would surround them and grant them your peace. For those who are planning such horrible acts, we pray, Lord, that they would see that this is not a good choice and they would find another outlet for their anger. Help us to look to you, O God, and we ask that you would heal our nation. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the sick, the sad, and the lonely. We pray for those who are grieving, especially the Yankich family and the Holmquist family and the royal family. We pray for those who are dying or nearing death, that their journey home to you would be safe and peaceful and uneventful. We pray for those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit, that your peace would rest with them as well. Hear now the names we lift before you who are in special need of your loving care as we speak them out loud or from within our hearts. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We thank you, Lord God, for the ways you use us in our neighborhood and beyond. We thank you for the quilters, for the food pantry, for the impressive collection of shoes in the food in the shoe barrel, and for the many other ways that you have yet to use us. We give you thanks. Please bless our efforts, Lord. Help us to be your presence, and the presence of your light and your love in this neighborhood, in our community, in our city, and beyond. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Into your hands, O God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting that you will hear and answer these prayers that we lift to you In the mighty and amazing name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The bread of life opens our eyes. The word of life opens our ears. The risen one shows us God's own brokenness. And by those wounds, we are healed. Peace be with you.
And also with you.
The one who calls us to repent hears us. In trust that our Creator knows us through and through, let us open our hearts to the healing of God's forgiveness. Good and gracious God, we are creatures of dust, ignorant of your revelation, misunderstanding your life, death, and resurrection among us, needing forgiveness. We repent of our failure to give as you have given to us. We beg your mercy for our fallen world. We seek your word that we may live with the faith of Jesus. Be our solace in this life and always. We ask this as your own children, holy and incomplete. Forgive us and lead us. Amen. In the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, our plea for absolution has been heard. God's promises are sure. Our sins are forgiven. Peace be with you. Amen. Amen. Thanks be to God. On the night before he died, our Lord Jesus took bread, he gave thanks, and he broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And again, after supper, he took the cup, he gave thanks, and he gave it to them to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, which is shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. For our friends at home, this is the body of Christ given for you, and the blood of Christ shed for you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Grant us peace. Deep the Father's love for us, how vast beyond all measure, that he should give his only Son to make a wretch his treasure.
Jesus Christ. as he's given, Jesus Christ, his Son.
And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich, because of what the Lord has done. Because he's given Jesus Christ his Son. And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich. Because of what the Lord has done.
May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ give us strength for today and hope for tomorrow. Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. Wellspring of joy, through this meal you have put gladness in our hearts. Satisfy the hunger still around us and send us as joyful witnesses that your love may bring joy to the hearts of all people. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
May our glorious God grant you the spirit of wisdom to know and love the risen Christ. The God of life, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit bless you now and forever. Amen. Amen.
Now all the vault of heaven resounds in praise of love that still abounds. Christ has triumphed, he is living. Sing choirs of angels loud and clear. Repeat the songs of glory here. Christ has triumphed, he is living. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Eternal is the gift he brings, therefore our heart with rapture sings. Christ has triumphed, he is living. Now still he comes to give us life, and by his presence still on strife. Christ has triumphed, he is living. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Christ has triumphed, he is living. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Adoring praises now we bring, and with the heavenly blessings sing. Christ has triumphed, alleluia.
Therefore, living with hope, let us share our joy and withhold our anger. May God help us shed our disappointments and turn to all people with gentleness. May we learn to embody all that Christ has taught us and give us all we need for each new day. Go in peace, live in hope, love like Jesus. We go in faith, reaching out, sharing grace. Thanks be to God. Hey, thanks to everyone for coming out this morning. Appreciate it. I think we've missed a lot of the deliveries and other things going on in the neighborhood, so that's very good. I think we've discovered that the threshold is about 45. That's about where I am anyway, 45 degrees. With the sun on my back, it's really not too bad. So hopefully we'll continue to have good weather, and rain will stay away on Sunday mornings, and we can continue to gather out here in the parking lot. We are going to have coffee this morning, so if you're at home, grab your cup of coffee, and I'll be just a couple minutes taking things down, and then I'll join you on Zoom. For those of you, if you're here, if you want to hang out and visit, we can do that. We just have to figure out where we're going to meet so I know where to find you. In the meantime, go in peace, and we'll see you next time. Take care.
Shine, Jesus, shine, fill this land with the Father's glory. Blaze, Spirit, blaze, set our hearts on fire. Flow, river, flow, flood the nations with grace and mercy. Send forth your word, Lord, and let there be love.
Your love is shining in the midst of the darkness, shining.
Jesus, light of the world, shine among us. Set us free with the truth you now bring us. Shine on me, shine on me. Shine, Jesus, shine. Fill this land with the Father's glory. Blaze, Spirit, blaze. Set our hearts on fire. Flow, river, flow, flood our nations with grace and mercy. Send forth your word, Lord, and let there be love.
As we gaze on your kingly brightness, so our faces display your likeness, ever changing from glory to glory.
Mirrored here, may our lives tell the story. Shine on me, shine on me.
Shine, Jesus, shine. Fill this land with the Father's glory. Blaze, Spirit, blaze. Set our hearts on fire. Flow, river, flow. Flood the nations with grace and mercy. Send forth your word, Lord, and let there be
you heard. Good morning.
Good morning.
How you doing, Gloria?
About the same.
No,
I haven't lost, the pain's still there, so I'm not sure the injection is working. I have said to wait till Monday morning and then call into the doctor's office.
Okay. Well, that's too bad because you were hoping to do some good.
Yep.
Bye.